Ready?
All right, so here we go. This highly anticipated fight is now underway. Looks like a classic matchup of striker versus grappler. Am I simplifying things too much?
In this instance, you aren't, because this is what got these two men to the show.
Right.
One guy is known for his diverse attack on the feet. The other guy is known for his ability to drag the fight to the mat.
Whoa! Trying to land the elbow there to no avail. Oh, big knee there. Big elbow there.
Beautiful punch.
Oh, man, another huge knee. That's hard to watch. So another swing and a miss, and I'd imagine if your gas tank is this low, you gotta find times to try to preserve that energy and get yourself back to a place where you can actually dole out some damage.
Yeah, you gotta get out.
Double leg takedown attempt here, and that is a good attempt as he gets the fight back to the mat.
It's ideal. His ideal situation just happened. He got in on the shot, didn't have to put too much effort to finish. Great job.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Curtis Blaydes. You wonder if the offensive fighter's gonna...
Wow! Who's hurt? Serve him up. Go get
now
him.
Goes in and secures the takedown. All right, half guard for him here, and a lot of offensive options, I would think, at his disposal.
Oh, he's got a ton of options. He has submission options, but I believe the safest option for him here is going to be to use his ground and pound. Build a base, posture up, throw big strikes, get back in position, build posture again, throw big strikes, and just really wear him down with a really secure position in half court.
A lot of top pressure being applied here. Back to the feet now. How about that shin? Beautiful combination there by Blaydes. Back to the well with that right hand. It's no good.
Great punch.
Quick entry to get him on a single.
That was a great single. Oh. He flips him over the top. What a huge takedown.
I mean, do I survive that, or did I read my
not
last one?
Absolutely not. You don't survive that. It's over. It's over, John.
Just over 2 minutes to go. Oh, beautiful jab by him there. Got that to the target quickly.
He dictated the fight with a jab. That jab.
That's his biggest strike as he has landed thus far tonight.
Big, massive shot lands. Look at how tough his opponent is, though. Still standing, still in their fight.
All right, he's got the full mount now. Is this one of the most dominant positions in MMA? Is that fair to say?
It's a very dominant position. It's one of the most ideal positions you can get to, especially if you are fighting someone that doesn't truly understand that they're not in as much danger as they are, because it's dangerous. But there are a lot of outs, and if a person isn't very understanding of that, then you can really, really put some damage on him.
Well, missed on that one. Got clipped with the right hand. Snap with that offering, DC, he is hurt.
What a beautiful uppercut. It landed beautifully. Perfect placement on that shot.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Strike lands there, and somehow his opponent's chin held up.
His opponent's chin held up, but you do not want to be on the receiving end of those types of strikes.
And he's able to work his way back to his feet. Whoa!
He's hurt. He's hurt bad.
Oh!
Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down.
All right, so he lands a jab there. Pretty nicely done, DC.
You can really control a fight just knowing how to fight behind your jab.
20 seconds left.
Big punch lands over the top. Oh, he's gonna follow. Double leg shot.
Oh, man, the canvas is shaking as he slams him down. Well, there are a few things entertaining scraps so far. All right, there's the horn indicating the end of the round, and how about the cut on that eyebrow? Oh, man, that's hard to look at even for me. It's gotten really, really bad here. You got to think they're going to call the doctor in here, and if it gets any worse, you got to think they have no choice.
Sit down. Catch your breath. Listen.
All right, back to the live action now, DC, as we get to the start of round two, the Black Beast Derek Lewis and Curtis Razor Blades. Oh, single collar tie here. There, his opponent could be out of here soon, DC.
He's almost done. I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, you don't know whether to run, tie, grab, or wrestle. He's confused. He's as confused as he was on his first test in elementary school.
And he caught the kick. We'll see what he can do with it. Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string it. Quick level change now.
He went single into a high crotch. Oh, he's taking this dude for a ride. Oh, takes it for a ride. What a fantastic takedown.
Well, he's got his back now. Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground. So.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition.
Blades is back in full mount. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do next.
He's gonna start looking to land big shot. Fight's over. He's done.
Beautiful shot to end the fight right there. It couldn't have landed much more flush than it did, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, quite frankly. So near perfect execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here tonight. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
Ready for the official decision, Bruce Buffer has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 1:04 of round number two, declaring the winner by knockout, Curtis Razor.
So the celebration is on with him and his team, and rightfully so. A monumental result tonight as he gets the win by knockout.
He spoke it into existence.
Coming up next, it is a heavyweight collision between Isaac Frost and Daniel Cormier.
Ready.
Well, always great to be back in the MMA hotbed that is Rio de Janeiro as we get underway here at the Juness Arena in Brazil. Oh, nice connection with that punch. It's one thing to have an edge in reach. It's another to take advantage. Nicely done. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by the cover. Oh, man, that leg's all beat up. Real sneaky body kick.
Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active.
Another massive body kick.
Oh, huge right hand! And he comes through with a big knee.
So a big win for him here tonight, and he made an even bigger statement by getting it by TKO.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean's called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 31 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by TKO, Daniel D.C.
Well, there he is, the man of the hour. And you got to think this dude's going to get a serious Instagram push tonight after the win by TK.
Oh, he's going to...
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight showdown. So here we go with round one, and on one side, clearly the more well-rounded fighter, yet when we sat down with him on Thursday, first words out of his mouth, he ain't gonna submit me, I'm gonna try to take him down.
Oh my goodness, and you laugh, but just like that, because you know how much of a joke this is. You wanna avoid the grappling with this guy at all costs. I know he has the body, I know he has a big ego, but it would benefit him to fight this fight and make it as easy as possible.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Very tricky when he throws that body kick. Holy smokes, he put him to sleep. Now he's on top of him looking for a
break. That is it!
Wow, what a performance!
Again, the winner here was so aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight.
So a big win for him here tonight, and a big statement made with that TKO. Let's see how the promotion chooses to matchmake him moving forward.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 42 seconds of the very first round, declaring the winner by TKO, Antonio Rodrigo Minotauro Nogueira.
Well, what a win for that young man tonight by TKO. And if the judges were looking at their phones, it's okay. We don't need their scorecards.
We don't need your scorecards. Do as you may.
Coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between The Boss and Fabricio Werdum.
Ready.
Well, the tension is palpable as this fight gets underway, and it's going to be interesting to see how this matchup plays out. Definite striker on one side against another guy who can really do it all.
And in those situations, normally the guy that's more well-rounded will be the one that will find success. I want to see how this plays out.
Oh, really using his reach advantage there as he lands the punch, DC. Whoa! Oh, big left. Perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman. Nice straight punch.
Able to check the high kick. Oh, beautiful strike there as he lands up top, and he does so right after catching the leg. So maybe you thought he would catch the leg and go for a takedown. Instead, he goes for the punch, and he certainly found the range on that one. Spinning back fist.
Big liver kick lands under the elbow.
So a nice job there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you will block the shot that's incoming. Real quick leg kick. Over and over. You come up, you go down. Another takedown lane.
All right, half guard position here, DC. You have an extra pop in your step when you talk about fighters working out of this half guard.
Oh, man. I like half guard as a top fighter. I understand half guard as a bottom fighter. Don't want to be there. It's
right.
Very dangerous. But if you are there, you have to be winning the position of the underhook. It opens up so many opportunities for you to either escape or sweep.
A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control, working off of his back here. Looks like he may try to hip escape. Back to the feet now. Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. And he's back up.
Nice strike.
Boom. Man, these guys are throwing back and forth. Huge block there. Oh, there is a land
match ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad with his head kick. Now he has to find one more strike to end the night.
A lot of top pressure being applied here. All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent.
Oh, and he's back up again. That's a huge shot right there, DC. You don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Gets up again here, but hurt.
He's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here.
Big kick land.
Oh!
Holy smokes! Oh, my goodness!
Beautiful shot to end the fight right there. It couldn't have landed much more flush than it did, and I'm not even sure the opponent saw it coming, quite frankly. So near-perfect execution on the strike that ultimately results in the KO here tonight. Well, we'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're going to find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight. But don't ignore all the work he did with his hands. And give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way. And in order to get a fight of the night like he got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 55 seconds in the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Fabricio Vergara Verdum.
Well, we congratulate him on a huge knockout here tonight. He'll probably keep that smile while he's sleeping tonight after what he was able to produce here.
He's going to be smiling for a...
Back on my bullshit. Back to back on my bullshit. Matter of fact, that was bullshit. I'm going back to back to back on my bullshit. Do it one time, they gon' think it's luck. Gotta hit him with a repeat. Do it two times, they gon' still doubt. Hey, now I got a three-peat. Gotta flood the streets till they knee deep. Gotta stay woke, can't be sleep. All this fly shit don't be cheap. All these bad bitches that we keep round. Pockets gotta be deep now. Never lose again, never lose again. Gotta keep winning, it's a clean sweep now. Tell her back it up, you hear three beeps now. Big truck, little bitch. Call me Greek Freak, big bucks.
All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight matchup between Ben Rothwell and Mark Coleman. All right, so here we go. Round one is underway. Very compelling matchup for fight fans around the world. And going to be very interesting to see how soon the grappler goes for the takedown.
Well, he's going to try to get the takedown right away. But when he shoots that shot, when he changes that level, he is going to be shooting into a guy that truly understands all aspects of mixed martial arts. Oh!
Oh, that's a good strike there by the King of Kenosha. Oh, a little single collar tie there.
Right hand hurt him a little bit.
Pretty nice knee there.
Oh! And just like that, the fight is over.
He's done, he's done. What a fight.
Yes, sir, it goes into the books as a first round win by knockout, near perfect execution. The technique was absolutely gorgeous. And again, when you catch a guy early, maybe you're getting him cold before he's had a chance to work up a sweat or even get into the fight a little bit. Those strikes can have a bigger effect, and it certainly did here tonight. Buffer has your official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 35 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Mark the Hammer Coleman!
celebration is on with him and his team, and rightfully so. A monumental result tonight as he gets the win by knockout.
He spoke it into existence.
Yeah, I be talking to myself like in the mirror and shit. Like, is you ready for this shit? Are you? What's up? I wasn't ready for that honey meal, but now I am. Remember being ready for war, then the gun jam. I guess God wasn't ready for him. Hey, you blessed. He wasn't ready for you, homie. I was born ready, day one. Since a child, I was groomed. I'm just me, and I ain't got no respect for a goon. Why not? A real killer kill by who they love. Rip from 94 in the split. You my plug, respect that. How many of you really know Mexicans? None of the Draco in the crowd, pedestrian, and look at you.
Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision. Well, DC's been all over this great nation. Fortaleza right on the equator. Tonight, though, we are in Rio de Janeiro. How's the flight, my man?
It's rough flying to Rio de Janeiro. It's far from me, coming from California. But the moment I step foot in here, I know that I'm in for a great fight, and I'm also in for a great crowd. People that are very knowledgeable about the sport of mixed martial arts and very passionate.
Oh, and there's another leg kick for good measure. So doing a really good job with that weapon here tonight. And if you're trying to slow your opponent down, mission accomplished so far.
When you can land that many leg kicks, you start to affect the movement. You start to affect the hands. Everything changes when you're blasting someone over and over and over with leg kicks. And you start to see the damage, not only in the legs, but in the facial expressions of the opponent.
All right, early round one, we'll see if he can use that jab and try to keep his opponent on the outside. Must be nice for these long fighters, huh?
I mean, they are able to touch you as you try to enter into range. Tonight, he needs to use his jab, use his kicks to hit his opponent before his opponent can get into range to even start to think about striking.
Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
Velasquez gets back up.
Yeah, he's hurt really bad.
He's got hurt here. Oh!
What a fight! On his feet right now.
Back to the feet. Oh, huge shot finds the target there.
Great shot lands. Now he's got to go find that follow-up attempt. The kill shot is what they call it to go and end the fight.
Oh, he's had a huge strike right there. I'm not sure how many more of these his opponent can take.
Massive shot that he landed. Great job.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Well, he works hard to get up again here, but he looks hurt. Oh!
An uppercut landed!
Oh! Oh, over the top. This fight's going to be over, DC.
What a great way of mixing up his attack. He didn't stay the course. He mixed it up. He went high with his opponent, but low. And now he's got him hurt very badly.
Oh! And both guys really throwing with authority.
Nice body kick.
All right, so he's landed a few big uppercuts already. And DC, I know you're in the prediction business. You think he's going to set it up again here?
I am certain he's going to try and set that up again. Expect it to come off of a left hook because off the left hook, don't anticipate the next punch comes right up the middle. He's real good at trying to find that shot.
Velazquez gets hit by that kick to the body. Again, going for the takedown, and once again, he won't get it.
It's because he does such a phenomenal job of timing his entries. Truly, truly inspiring to watch.
All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Both fighters get up now. That is a huge shot right there, DC. You don't want to eat too many more of those.
No, and he needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, that's got to be discouraging as he gets right back up again. So a nice shot there defensively to raise the guard and prevent any damage.
Those hands never leave where they're supposed to be. And if you do that, most times you...
So aggressive with his onslaught. He wanted to make sure he kept the judges out of the equation. Mission accomplished on that front as he gets the TKO victory here tonight. We'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're going to find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight, but don't ignore all the work he did with his hands and give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way. And in order to get a fight of the night like you got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
All right, we sent it inside for the official decision. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean is going to stop this contest at 4 minutes, 54 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kane!
The man of the moment, and what a moment this must be like for a professional athlete, right? I know you enjoyed the birth of your kids, right?
Yeah.
But you knock out a man in a cage fight, I can't think of anything better.
I mean, there's nothing like it. You know, you don't even hear the one that lands that puts out your opponent's lights. And tonight, you got that done. And you should be very proud of the work he and his coaches got done tonight.